When you think of Magic the Gathering, do you think about sadism, cruelty, and torture? No? What if I told you those did exist? Let's take a look.
When does a hero's journey begin? The moment you step outside the safety of your homes? Or when you realize the fight has just begun? Is it when you comprehend how small you are compared to the vastness of what threatens to destroy you?
Greetings, everyone. Thanks for watching. I'm Jay the Filthy Casual, your host tonight. No one would ever think that sadism, cruelty, and someone enjoying that fun would ever make it into Magic the Gathering. But I think this is what makes old wizards great. The fact that they would have multiple different story arcs, multiple different capacities for, characters, and the fact that they represent a good portion of all the aspects of life, up to and including sadism. Now, if you haven't guessed by the title that we're actually going to try and, talk a little bit about Tibalt. Now, Tibalt started his life as a human on Innistrad, experimenting on vermin and eventually working his way up to humans. Now, his experiments at an early start started gathering devils, the devils on Innistrad, to him, and they would chatter and chitter and as he performed these acts on his unsuspecting prey. And they would give him insights and whatnot. So it's been almost a decade since we've heard anything from Tibalt, and hasn't really appeared in any story until maybe now, which may start a new story arc for the Lost Planeswalker. He doesn't have a lot of lore surrounding him. He has more of a very short biographical summary instead of appearing directly in a storyline, which I think has been more of a disservice, because I feel that there's more to this character that could play out in both ways, either going more evil and ending up like Bolas, or in the range of redemption, finding the errors of his ways while being out in the multiverse. Now, he never returned and never had a second printing as a card, with the exception of an alternate art that came out in a dual deck, which pitted him against Sorn, who is one of the very original planeswalkers who walked the multiverse as gods before the mending. And he was considered so bad that he was only ever considered a joke. And a quick check on Google Images will show you that, there'll be the five planeswalkers playing Magic the Gathering around a table, and you got Tibalt looking through the window going, "I wish I could be them. I wish I could play with them, but I can't because I suck." And then you have other pictures of Tibalt, which I found amusing today, which is like a Sandra and a Tibalt, and they're fighting together, and it goes, "How about a kiss?" And then it turns out it's just Tibalt playing with dolls in bed. That was pretty funny. But with all seriousness aside, what I wanted to really bring this to is kind of a quick review of his background. So basically, he was a human on Innistrad. He performed experiments on people, animals, all sorts of beings, and caught the eye of the devils. The devils were coming, and they would watch him perform these acts. As I previously stated, they would chatter and chitter and give him ideas. But eventually he caught the eye of an inquisitor who kicked down the door, basically, and cornered him into a room, at which point he started casting a spell. Now, the spell basically merged his essence with the essences of all the devils in the room, and inflicted a great deal of pain on him. Basically, all the pain he ever inflicted on anyone else was coursed through his veins at a single instant. And I would assume at a molecular level, which I would also assume would be very, very painful. At which point, as the door was kicked in, he does his planeswalker thing and he's never heard from again. But the real question is, where has he been and what has he been doing? A lot of people seem to think that because it's Magic the Gathering, that there's this linear arc. He's gone, he must be doing nothing, right? This can't be the case. He's gone somewhere and he's doing something. Even the people on Ixalan who were stuck there were still doing something. Even the planeswalkers, the people who knew they were powerful, were stuck there and still doing something. Whether it was becoming a pirate king like Angrath, or if it was Vraska or Jace losing his memory and becoming a better person and then, you know, doing Jace's thing like he always does. But what I suspect happened is two things. One, and both of them kind of involve him getting more powerful. So one, he went to another plane of existence, which we may or may not have seen yet. Maybe he went to New Phyrexia, who knows? And either trained, was trained, and became better. Because if you look at this new IDW comics cover, he looks pretty badass. And you don't do that by, you know, sitting around all day on a beach drinking mojitos. You work hard and you become better. Now, going with this comic book cover, which, to my understanding, isn't the final release. It's more of a, a feeler. I'm going to say a feeler because a lot of people got bent out of shape. And I suspect it will be changed. But a lot of people went from 0 to 100 on this. Now, the thing I don't like is how they just kind of fill in the blanks and assume the worst. I mean, I'm kind of doing the same, but I'm not making this to an over-sexualized, woman-beating video. Well, he is standing over top of her. Her posture and his posture are not indicative of them fighting, especially where they're looking. You could literally take lines from the eyes, and if you go far enough off the screen, they would meet at a singular target. He's not looking down at her. She's not worried about him. And if the artist was drawing it in that sense, he portrayed human interaction perfectly. Because everything I've been trained to do, one of them is not to turn your back on the enemy under any circumstances. Because you can't defend yourself. Now, some people are going to say, oh, he may have backhanded her and she twisted around and ended up on the ground and she's, you know, stunned looking away. But that's not the case. The way she's sitting, it doesn't show that, you know, he could have backhanded her or punched her or whatever. And if he did, his hand is on fire. There'd be more than nothing on any side of her face. I'm sure the artist would have paid attention to the detail and put a char mark on her cheek or something to that effect, right? But you don't see any of that in this poster. While he is standing over top of her, I think that's the only thing that you could maybe equate to him exuding his power over her. But that's not the case. I think he may have been sitting back and, hey, you burned two Eldrazi Titans. You got this. Go. I'll just sit back and watch. You know, I'm a nobody anyways. I'm just a planeswalker with no major abilities except taking everything in play and throwing it at your face if I live long enough, which never happens, even in tiny leaders. But go on. Fight Oh, you just got your ass kicked? Okay, well, let's see what I can do. And power up. And you see that. He's standing there in his stance, and he's got his arms up, and the one right hand's on fire, his dagger's still there, he hasn't pulled it yet, so it's like, okay, well, you've had your turn. Let's go. Let me try now. You know, I've been gone for 6 years of real time, which could be any number of years in the magic universe. Or maybe he ended up in a plane of existence where time moves three times faster than the rest of the multiverse. Who knows? You know, physics. Quantum physics, at that matter. With that being said, it's interesting to see how this will play out, because I honestly think that with this cover will come a new storyline, and I think he'll honestly be a... if he does come back as a planeswalker, he'll be a red, red-black planeswalker. And he'll he'll probably have some destroy abilities or something. But I think he's gonna be a very welcomed surprise. Now, there was a video that Talarian Community College did earlier in the year about Tibalt, and you know, he thinks that things may have changed. The video was back in June or July. That bringing him back after he's been such a mockery would be a disservice to the card game. And I don't think that's the case. I think with a proper story arc, I think he'll be a very welcomed character and a breath of fresh air. Something that gets away from the whole cookie cutter planeswalker of, you know, Gideon, Jace, Sandra, Nisa, and all that. I think it'll build up to something better and new. With that being said, I appreciate you guys taking the time to come see me for this this video, and see you again soon. I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual, former Knight of the Roundtable, and member of the Phoenix Syndicate. Thank you for watching. If you liked this video and would like to see more like it, click the like button and subscribe. To be notified, don't forget the bell, because we all know YouTube won't do it. If you would like to support the cause further, you can donate at the links below. And I would like to thank the current supporters, because without you, this wouldn't be possible. And remember to support your local game store, as they are in the brick and mortar of the games community. I'm Jay the Filthy Casual, and thanks for stopping by.